Hello and welcome to Ruchi's Town. In today's video, we're going to see a recipe on how to make gutti vankaya kura or stuffed brinjal. This is called as enna kadrika in Tamil. I'm going to make this along with some gravy, so it can be had with rice. Let's see how to make this recipe. For this recipe, I've taken the purple round brinjal. You can even use the white brinjal. Along with this, we would need sesame seeds, curry leaves, onions, tomatoes, red chilies, ginger, garlic, coconut, turmeric, cumin, coriander powder, oil and salt. We are going to take 2 tablespoons of oil in a pan and add some sesame seeds to it and fry for about a minute till it gets roasted. So add ginger and garlic into it. Then add chilies, red chilies, both Kashmiri varieties and the spicy variety. Kashmiri variety will give you nice color to the mixture. So next we are going to add onion. I have taken one big onion. If you have small onions, you have to add 2 or 3 of them. And along with this, I am going to add some tomatoes as well. The tomatoes is hybrid variety and I'm going to just add 2 small tomatoes. Don't put more tomatoes to get the color, because if you add in more tomatoes, it is going to become tangy. So fry this well till the onions become translucent and the raw smell goes away. So once that is done, we are going to put 2 tablespoons of grated coconut into this mixture, and along with that, we are going to put cumin powder, turmeric powder, coriander powder and salt. Mix this well for about a minute or so, then get it to room temperature and grind it well into a fine paste. Don't add water while making the paste. Now take the brinjal and cut it twice like a plus shape. Check if the brinjals are good and start stuffing the brinjals. Repeat this for all the brinjals and keep it aside. So once you are done, you will have some stuffing left as well. We are going to use it finally to make the gravy. Add oil in a pan. I have taken canola oil and put some curry leaves into it. The pan that you use should be wide enough so that you could kind of spread in all the brinjals evenly and the brinjal is in contact with the pan as much as possible. So stir it occasionally and cook it on all the sides. This can be eaten with roti or dosa as well. Apart from rice, you can make it thick or you can put in more water and make it more like a gravy as well. So depends totally upon for what you're making this side dish for. Press the tips of the brinjal as much as possible towards the pan so that it gets cooked well. That is the place where it doesn't actually cook on most of the times. So this would take nearly 10 minutes. Keep stirring and frying. As it is getting cooked, the color of the brinjals turn darker. So you could actually take a knife and put it through the brinjal to see if it's cooked or not. So once that is almost 80% cooked, add in the leftover gravy and the water that is left from the mixer grinder and mix it well. Add more water than the thickness that you would actually need, because it has to cook for some time and the brinjals have to get cooked. For that, it will take some time and the water will get evaporated during that time. Now you could check the taste and add more salt or chili powder if you require. Keep stirring it occasionally. Put a lid on and it will take between 10 to 12 minutes for the brinjals to be completely done. So if you see, the color of the gravy has turned darker and even the brinjals. Now it's all done. Serve it hot with roti, rice or even dosas. Try this recipe out and let me know how it comes out. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Ruchi's Town.